So I thought I'd do a report to do two things for you guys tonight. The first is I want to go over the CPI number, and it came in very, very good. You saw the stock market, I think it ended up over 200 or 300 points, and you saw mortgage rates, I won't say plummeted, but they're down probably about a quarter across the board. And they're probably, a lot of banks probably aren't even doing anything. They're probably just sitting on the sidelines waiting, okay, tomorrow it's going to probably give some back or so forth. So a lot of banks probably haven't even repriced to lower their rates even further, because I'm going to show you at the end of the video where the MBS market is right now. We should be at least 3/8 of a reduction in rate from where we were just yesterday. So I'm going to give you that data here in a little bit as well. One other thing we're going to talk about in this video, and I'm going to make it fast, folks, is the crash is here and we're at the bottom of it. And I'm going to explain what I mean by that. So I hope you, when you watched my or looked at my thumbnail, you're not, oh, please, Dan, don't jump on this crash bandwagon. It's crash, folks, and it's crash. It's down over 40% in some areas. But the numbers and with the data that I'm going to give you might be a little surprising. So what we want to talk about, the first thing is what the CPI number came in. Now, this is the inflation number for the consumers. Like me and you as a consumer, what do? Well, we have our cars fixed, and we buy frozen vegetables, and we have car insurance, and we buy candy and chewing gum and all those. So those are the things really killing us right now. But if you could go down through this chart, there's one number in here that equates out to a third of this. And I know you guys are probably getting sick and tired of this, but it is a huge thing to do. Right here, you have rents. Here, let me go over through here. Rents as a of the primary residency. Okay. This figure is showing an 8.3% increase from where we were. Now, yes, that was it, but that number was representative about December of last year. Where we are now, this number is more in the tune of between 3.7 and 4. Okay, so when this comes in and they actually adjust this to maybe the 4 handle, how much more is this going to drop? Well, we're going to be right in line to where the Federal Reserve wants us. The big ticket items that I've been telling you guys about is right down through here. We all use gasoline daily. We all use health insurance daily, or we pay it. Airfares, well, for those who travel, airfares are way up. Utilities, we use every day. And energy, we use every day. Look at all three of those factors. All three of those are down between 16 and 27%. That's what's really pushing down these numbers. So I kept saying, guys, look, you got to follow what utilities are doing in energy, and now it's starting to click. Okay, so that's the first thing we want to go over. Next thing we want to go over is the crash. Okay, here's the crash. Okay, so let's go back. Everybody wants to pinpoint the time period of, you know, 2006, 2008, 2010. So let's go back to 2000, the peak of all this. We had 7.25 million homes were on the market for sale. Okay, that was right here. Why were those for sale? Why so much? This is an anomaly. Look, this is the maximum chart that there is, basically in history. Why at that time frame were there so many houses for sale? Subprime mortgages that push people out of their homes. That's why you had it completely plummet. And the reason why is people were forced to sell their houses. Okay, so that's what happened. So we went with a handle right here. They were 7.2, I think it's 25 million. Okay, so remember that number, 7.25 million. Then where were we just during the COVID pandemic where everybody was buying houses crazily? What was 6.85 million? Okay, so we got 7.25, 6.85 million. Where are we right now? We're right here. Let me get that. 7.28 million. Okay, there's your crash. Now, to make this simple for you guys, I reached out to ChatGPT to figure out these numbers. So if you take the number that we had from just a year or two ago, 6850 that I represented on the chart there, and where we are today, 4280, the difference is there's a 37.5% decline in the number of units sold, 37%. Well, let's go from the peak where everybody wants to use, well, 2006, 2008, you know, it's the same as that. Well, there was 7.25 million homes on the market, existing homes. What is there today? 4280. What's that a difference of? Well, in ChatGPT, they made it 40.97%. So a 40% reduction in the number of existing homes for sale. That's the key. So now you have very limited supply. So people that do want to buy a house are basically forced to pay that price or not buy a house. Okay. So this is your crash. It's here. I've seen it. But everybody kept referencing how much the prices were going to drive down or plummet. And I never expected that. I expected this. Okay, so that's that part of that. So now based on the CPI information that we have today, what's going on with mortgage rates? Well, I had a video out this morning that they're plummeting. A lot of you guys looked at MBS or Mortgage News Daily for the rates. They're lagging so much, so I would check on them tomorrow, but they do their best they can. But right here on your screen, what you're seeing right here is what's happening to mortgage-backed securities, a bond that trades on Wall Street. You can't see the number up through here, but it's down 80. What that means is we should have at least a reprieve in interest rates of at least 3/8. Okay, what is it going to do tomorrow? I don't know. There might be some, you know, profit taking or whatever, but tomorrow is also another big number. It's the producer inflation numbers. Now, I'm expecting that number to come in as well. So as that's coming down, companies hopefully will be able to start driving down their prices. So then that'll in turn move over to the CPI, because you got to remember the producer prices, if their numbers are coming down, hopefully they pass the savings on to the consumer. So then our consumer prices come down, bringing everything in the line. Will that happen? I don't know. Only time's going to tell. So if you like my videos and you're like, hey, Dan, what do you do? I'm a mortgage advisor. I would love to be able to help you try to get pre-qualified for a house. Maybe you have a ton of equity in your home and you just need to pay off some bills. We can help you do that as well. Or maybe you're just like, how much can I afford? What kind of credit scores do I need? How much money do I need as a down payment? If you have questions like that, all I ask you to do is go over to therateupdate.com. This is my website, and reach out to us. Best way to do it is right through here. You can give us a call at 844-775-5626, or probably one of the best ways to do it, just click the apply now button. You're going to answer a few questions within 24 hours. Somebody's going to be getting you on the phone or Zoom or however you want to be contacted to go over any questions that you have and work with you to get you into the programs or into the situation you want to get into. So that's my report for today. All I ask you to do is one thing for me. Please just give me a thumbs up. I'd love it. And it helps us get found by many more people on YouTube. So thanks you so much for watching. Sorry to do two videos today, but I thought this was important enough to reach out to you guys. So God bless. I'll see you tomorrow morning, folks.